In the First World War, there was a song that the soldiers would sometimes sing, "We're here because we're here, because we're here because we're here." And the second verse went, "We're here because we're here, because we're here because we're here." And then it was repeated. And in fact, you can find a recording of a soldier in 1916 singing it. Now, I'm not for 1 minute suggesting that the soldiers didn't know that they were serving their country in that war. But there were times during the fighting when that sense of pointlessness, as they saw their comrades being killed, that sense of endless suffering, led to them singing some of those songs to keep themselves human, to keep themselves sane. Being here, though, is a very important concept psychologically. Are you here today? Now, of course, you are, but are you really here spiritually? Or is your mind thinking of the royal wedding yesterday? Or of the Manchester United defeat? Or are you thinking of your Sunday roast? Or of something happening tomorrow? As you receive the sacrament in a few minutes' time, will you be here spiritually? Here to receive, here to be attentive, here to be alive. One of the key thoughts in my own personal journey to faith when I was 18 was when I was on a camel in Egypt. And I realized that even though I was in these idyllic surroundings with pyramids near me and on this camel, my own inner spirituality was weak and empty, and I needed to grow in my own inner state. I knew that the holiday I was on was not the answer to life. That however much we might try and enjoy the external surface of our life, I needed inner change. And Pentecost Sunday is about discovering inner change through the life of faith, through the life of spirituality, through an encounter with that divine spirit. In a world so focused on the external, on the moment, the present moment in terms of entertainment, in terms of what is getting to your external senses, we see an ever-increasing number of people suffering from inner emptiness, loneliness, fragmentation, depression, anxiety, and an ever-increasing need and relevance of our spirituality and the spirituality of faith. We saw that at the wedding yesterday, didn't we? However beautiful the dresses were of the different people, however beautiful the chapel was, however many celebrities there were, the thing that really hit people was the spirituality coming from different parts of the service, whether that be the sermon, which a lot of people liked, or the prayers, or the spiritual message of inclusiveness that the service represented. So we're here because we're here because we're here. We can be here physically, but are we here spiritually? The Christian journey is a journey where we move from simply being fixated with the external circumstances of this world and become increasingly caught up in our internal journey with God, which doesn't detach us from that external journey, but nourishes it and strengthens it. Because the paradox is, as we grow spiritually, it will help us with our external life. That's at least the theory, though I know there are lots of hurdles on the way and dark tunnels that we have to go through. When we had our weekend away, the Dean of Canterbury was talking about journey and story. And I thought it was really useful when he said during his address, something that I hadn't realized when I planned the weekend with Anne and Terry and Martin and various other people. And that is that journey and story, we use that word interchangeably to begin with. But he pointed out they're two very different things. You can have a journey to Canterbury on the bus. You can stub your foot as you got into the bus. You could be sitting in front of a group of youths who are singing very loudly, make it hard for you to hear your neighbour who you're talking to. Nothing against youths, by the way. It just happens to be on this bus. You can get out of the bus and it can be raining. And then when you get to the shop, the thing that you've come to buy is not available, so your journey is wasted. But at the same time, you can have a story as you go on that journey. Talking to your neighbour, sharing good news, perhaps being nice to the youths behind you, giving them a nice smile. Perhaps helping someone across the road as you arrive in Canterbury. Perhaps praying a little bit as you journey through the rain. And when you get back at the end of the day from your wasted journey, your story is your own internal experience of that journey. Your story can be positive, even though your journey has been negative. How many times have I seen people whose story has collapsed? Broken marriage, health problems, employment problems, sickness problems. And yet somehow in the dust and ashes of the broken journey, they found a spiritual story. I think that's what the bishop was preaching about yesterday, about the story of love that comes out of the journey of slavery, which he referred to. And talking about Martin Luther King, out of that terrible journey was the oppression of black people, came a new story of hope and spirituality. The slave gospel movement, the gospel movements came out of that slavery heritage. So the Christian privilege we have in our society is that we are able to separate journey from story. A prisoner is someone who is imprisoned by their journey, by their surroundings, by what is happening to them in the here and now, who is completely at the mercy of the events of the day. Did you have a good day? No, I didn't, because this and that happened. That's a prisoner, because they have no freedom inside of themselves to find God, to find spirituality, to find the spirit, despite the circumstances going wrong. A person who is set free, a person who is full of the spirit, is someone who can find Christ and joy and peace despite the circumstances of the day. Now, I'm sure you're thinking, I'm not there yet. I'm still very much at the mercy of the circumstances of the day. I'm not one of those people who can just walk through each day and know the peace and love of God. Well, you're not alone. I'm in that category too. I'm also at the mercy of the circumstances of each day, but I'm trying to put one foot in the kingdom of the Spirit. I'm trying to grow in the love and knowledge of Christ and the experience of knowing him spiritually. And that's my story. And I want it to try and be your story. Will you try and find Christ in life, in the good times and in the bad? Will you try and grow spiritually, no matter what is happening in the external circumstances of life? Will you try and grow in that knowledge of the Spirit who was poured out on the early church on the day of Pentecost? If so, if you're willing to grow in that direction, pray to God today and ask him for strength that you may grow in your spirituality, in your experience of Christ, so that you are not at the mercy of the external circumstances, so that you are walking close to him, close to his spirit each day. As we have the laying on of hands after communion, we won't be praying directly for this, but as we pray for those who come forward, the Spirit will be there, I believe, and we'll be praying that you may know the nourishing of the Spirit, his presence, the spiritual life, in all the good and the bad of the surface of life that you experience. And if you can find God in that, if I can find God in that, it's one huge step forward for our lives spiritually in an increasingly materialistic and superficial society in which we live. Come, Holy Spirit, be our story. Come, Holy Spirit, fill us afresh with your presence. Come, Jesus, set us free. Come, Holy Spirit. Amen.